first heard about the project from my sister Tracy, who works at Iowa State and somehow found out about all this. And she's like, well, hey, did you know Iowa State was looking for volunteers to start the project or be a part of the project? So I said, no, I didn't, but if it's for Iowa State and it's for the Iowa Pork Producers Association, I'll give her a go. As far as I'm concerned, if we can all have good conversations about positive things, working together and partnering on projects like this on a small scale now, people like you and I can go and do the footwork and broaden everyone's horizons in the industry about, hey, we can make this work. It's just starting it is always the hardest part and it's the most critical part. So if you can get something started right, I think that it can go far and be a positive influence on a lot of different people. You know, people that care about the environment, people that want to conserve energy, people that want to produce pork, people that want to raise corn. I think that as long as we can have an open-ended conversation about starting these projects together, not necessarily forcing them on anyone, and then just having people like me and you go around and kind of do the footwork and, you know, it's really just it's an easy conversation to have, but it's hard to ask the right questions. And I think as long as we're open-minded and we're all working together, then we can go from there and make something like this possible on a larger scale. Oh, I wasn't skeptical about much. They asked me why we were digging up the backyard and what was going on back there, and I was like, well, it's a project for Iowa State and Iowa Pork Producers Association, and then they all started making fun of me when the grass or natural prairie started to grow because it looked like a weed patch, and obviously as farmers in Iowa we hate weeds, so they were just giving me heck about it, and but we're all over it now, and now it's kind of an inside joke about how the butterflies are doing and everyone's always asking about it. So everything grew really fast and just kind of did what Seth had asked, and it came together, and now I guess it's a really great habitat for monarchs and other species of butterflies. I suggest that anybody tries anything that Iowa State asks of them, because, I mean, we're here for them and they're here for us, obviously, creating a monarch habitat in our backyards to help a hidden gem of Iowa that a lot of America doesn't understand and doesn't see is a good thing. This guy's got like a third of this leaf eaten off over here.
Good, good.
How much of that can he eat, you think?
He'll eat the whole thing.
From top to bottom?
Well, the whole plant. No, I mean, if you left him there. Like, if he'd been on that plant since he was born, like, yeah. Yes, he'd eat most of the plant. They eat a ridiculous amount of biomass.
Hmm.
They also poop a lot.
Interesting.